Jason, I'm Nikkie.
I'm Nick.
And together we're Nikkie Nick.
Today. And I'm excited.
Yes.
Because I'm really curious.
Yes. So we are going to
reacting
to Camila Cabello visits a psychic and reveals her songwriting secrets.
In real life.
Yes. So this is a long waiting video that we promised you guys we would do about Camila. We're just now doing it and we apologize, but we've had so many requests, so we're just trying to make it fair for everyone.
Also, if it gets taken down, because we've never done a video by Genius before.
I don't think we have.
And I'm hoping we'll put it in our Google Drive.
Yeah, I'm hoping that it stays up, but I took off my sock in the video.
Nice.
But if it does get taken down, we'll update that in our Google Drive. While we're talking about that, our Google Drive, we've had two videos that we're going to be posting in it in the next few days that were taken down.
Yeah, recently. So we'll be putting those in there for you.
It was the Zayn and Gigi moments,
and then the Pentatonics
Bohemian Rhapsody was taken down, unfortunately.
So well, check that out. It'll be on our Google Drive.
Go to our Google Drive in the next day or two, and it'll be posted. But anyway, you ready?
Yep.
I'm excited.
Well, also, we've been talking about wanting to go do a psychic.
We have.
I really want to. Too. Very professional one, though.
Yes.
I don't. But as soon as I walk in there, I'll be like, no depressing stuff, please. Thank you. Positive stuff.
Just
only.
Leave out anything that's going to make you really sad.
You're gonna die tomorrow. Oh, great. Now I'm gonna spend that last day upset.
Well, I mean, I feel like I'd want to know both.
Yeah. Just positivity.
Oh, okay.
Because I feel like if you go in there and they tell you something negative,
then you're gonna harp on the negativity.
Yeah, it's like, oh, in 10 years, you're gonna stub your toe. And it's like, oh, great. Now I'm gonna dwell on that until
what an interesting thing.
Just lightning in the blow.
Yeah, gotcha. So. All right, you ready?
Yep.
I want to know all about this.
Here we go! What a very interesting start. You see, Will?
Mm-hmm.
There you go, Booba.
Thanks.
Camila, I feel like you're a different type of artist.
Thanks.
And for a different type of artist, I wanted
to... this seems really
kind of
serious.
Interview.
Yeah.
This is definitely different.
So I brought my friend Lily along with
me. Hi,
her.
Lily.
Hi, how are you?
Nice to meet
you.
My friend Lily.
I am a third generation.
She looks very familiar.
I would like to do a reading for you today.
Sure.
Telling you past, present, future, business, sickness, health, and love affair.
Oh, that's cool. Oh,
wow. I've never done anything like this before.
I think I want to see her.
I'm going to actually have you shuffle this deck of tarot.
Okay.
And I would also like you to cut those in three with your right hand when you are done.
Interesting.
Please hand those over to me. It is important that through this reading you understand not to get upset. I'm just going to tell you what Spirit is showing me today. Some things you will understand now, sometimes you won't understand until you're actually going through that.
That's really cool.
So even later on today, some things might just come back and hit you.
Okay.
I'm going to actually do a three card spread out for you.
Okay.
And then as I'm going through the reading at the end, you can feel free to ask me any questions. I'd ask you not to volunteer any information. Just so I can, until I can pick up a vibe on you.
Okay.
This is actually giving me chills. This is
not gonna lie. I came in as a non-believer. Mm-hmm. I didn't want to tell her that, I didn't want her to feel. I'm not sure if I'm a believer now, but 98% of what she said.
No, I don't want to see this.
She
go back. I don't want to. I hate that.
You know, coming in, we didn't tell her.
Like they know something I haven't seen yet.
Yeah. Tell who we're gonna sit down with, because that feels like. Cheating.
Yeah, because then she could just Google what the last year and a half of my life
right.
is.
Right.
True.
The breakup? Not too long ago.
But how do you feel?
I'm not going to lie. It was a little bit overwhelming just because there's so much information coming at you. And, you know, in your mind, you're trying to
piece it.
Connect the dots, what she's saying to, you know, what's actually going on or how it can pertain to your reality. So that's what I was doing the whole time. And if she didn't know who I was at all, then that's actually... pretty crazy.
Wow. Okay, so it's not what each card means individually.
Okay.
But it's what all cards mean all together.
Okay.
I almost feel like you didn't start out with this idea. Like you had another plan, you had another journey that you was planning for your life's career. And then I feel something happened, and this was actually a hidden talent that you ended up finding out about yourself.
So true, yeah. Wow, that's crazy.
I'm so interested. Sorry, y'all guys. I'm going to comment at the end. I'm so into this.
Me too. crazy how she looks so different but so much the same.
Yeah. Only silence at its ending, like
we never had a chance. God, that was 7 years ago almost.
Right away of doing music?
I initially was not trying to do music at all. I mean, I came to the United States, my family came, and my parents made that choice. My mom came over to Miami, and her main thing was just like, we don't have money to get you into college, so you're gonna have to get a scholarship, and you're gonna have to study your butt off. And so that was always my main focus, was just, I was like a book nerd. I was just like studying. So I didn't really think of it as a plausible thing, even though it was always my escape. You know, I would always sneak off into my room when my parents went to Walmart, and I would just like sing. But yeah, I definitely didn't think of it as a career. That was literally just like 5 seconds of bravery that changed my life, where I decided to, you know, try out for a show.
We asked Camila, what do you want for your quinceañera party? And she told me, I want you to go with me to an audition.
What do you do when you're not singing?
I would love to say something interesting, but all I do is sing karaoke and watch like One Direction videos. Years ago, someone told me I should take caution when it comes to love.
You're a very nurturing and loving person. The reading does show here that when you love somebody and you care for somebody, you will give them your all, your shirt off of your back. Sometimes you overgive, you give too much. But I think that when you're finished with something, you're finished and you just walk away.
Wow.
The thing is I know you guys have potential, but I feel like tonight there was only one person that shined. You.
Oh, snap.
Okay, we have...
Which one?
It took a little interrogation.
We all shined. Camila? Yes, I think you guys should all learn something from her.
Talk about a little bit. I mean, I obviously when Fifth Harmony started to merge, and next back when the show takes off and you guys as a group, you know, better together, reflection.
Yeah.
Did you feel like you made it? Was it this feeling of accomplishment? Like, what were you going through as the group started to take off and you were part of that?
It felt really great from a level of, man, we've worked so hard. Our families have sacrificed so much. But I definitely felt like when Work From Home became, like, a really big song, or when, you know, songs of ours started to get played, I wanted to, like, feel more when I heard it on the radio, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. I learned so much. I'm so grateful for that whole experience. I don't even think that I would have felt like that yearning to even start writing to express myself if it weren't for the fact that, you know, I was singing songs that I didn't really connect to. Like, I did a song with Shawn Mendes, I know we did last summer. That song was not nearly as successful as Work From Home. If it came on in the radio, I was like, whoa, like, this is about something that happened to me. Like, you know what I mean?
Right.
And it, even though it wasn't as successful, I just felt more.
And I get
that's
that,
really
right?
Cool.
Like having this tremendous success.
It's understandable,
proud,
definitely
but maybe not feeling as connected to a song as you feel like you should be.
It shows a lot about you writing. It's almost as if you're going to have a little fear of going in that direction, but I really don't think that you need to, because once you let go of that fear, you're going to move forward, and it's going to turn out very positive in your favor.
Wow.
I thought it was over for a second.
I was going to be really upset.
Yeah, they just cut me out.
It's totally 100% you.
I would get instrumentals from songs that already existed. So I have these demos where you hear, like, the music is from, like, Born to Die by Lana Del Rey. Mm-hmm. And I wrote, like, a whole other song over it.
Wow.
And that's how I basically started to develop my voice as a songwriter. When I got into the studio to really, for the first time, to work on this album, which was January, everybody was kind of... They came in with this attitude of like, oh, I have an idea for you. Like, play it for me. And I was like, let's do something from scratch. And they were like, oh, you actually write. Like, you actually have a point of view. You actually have something that you want to talk about today. Like, I'm so happy that I started writing those, like, shitty demos on the road, because if it weren't for that, I wouldn't have even had the confidence to be like, oh, I want to do this today, guys, and as opposed to just taking something. But I wouldn't have even known where to start.
I have to imagine, just, you know,
I was wondering how she, like, got
that you had being able to write to Havana.
Yeah. The best part about that song was I played it for my grandma, and my grandma loves music. Mm. I put headphones on her ears, and you know when the first verse comes in, he didn't want bum bum bum. She was like, yeah. And I was like, yes. And I played it for my grandpa too, and he loved it. And that was the best part, is just getting to see my grandma just kind of have like a piece of her culture, like in my music. It's like it's that kind of thing that I was telling you. Like when you have a song like that and people like it, it feels so special, because it's like, damn, this is my heart, and you're like singing along to a piece of me. Like, that's so cool.
I read somewhere that you tricked Pharrell in the studio.
Yeah, I did.
You played a trick on Pharrell.
Yeah, because he was like, you know, Quavo and all these people, like the, you know, the rap ad libs that are literally make the song. It's just like why the energy feels like a. And so he was like, it would be so cool, because you know, you're a pop singer, you're a girl, if you were doing like these kind of like hardcore like rap ad libs. And so I just know that Pharrell has magic in his voice, and he could just say, hey, and it just all of a sudden sound freaking sick. And so I was just like, you know, could you just like sketch it out, and then I'll like redo it. And so he just went into the studio and does like the whole pass. And I was like,
The other thing that the reading is coming up is there's going to be something going on with somebody that you're going to take concern for.
Oh, God.
And I almost feel like this person is going to try to distance themselves, maybe even react angry. They want to open up to you, but they don't feel like they can, but they will.
That is actually going on right now. It's crazy.
It's something to your past, almost like a grudge, I want to say. It's something that you need to face, but you need to let go of in order for you to move forward for your future.
Wow, that's beautiful.
Too young to be this hurt. I feel doomed in hotel rooms, staring straight up at the wall, counting wounds, and I'm trying to numb them all. Do you care? Do you care? Why don't you care? I gave you all of me, my blood, my sweat, my heart, and my tears. Why don't you care? Why don't you care?
When you were leading up to release, I Have Questions, it was a really great Instagram post that you put.
There was so much power in that.
Described the
I'm like getting like song came together. Sucked in right now.
And that's the type of stuff that genius loves. Before we get a song that we really love, this is the seed that's planted. Do you remember where you were when you wrote I Have Questions?
I wrote I Have Questions 4 different times.
Wow.
It was just like an idea that I had on my phone, because it was just during a time of my life where I was just like, there was just like a situation where I was just so confused about like what was going on. I had like a friend and we were like so close. And then it was like, literally it was like a day after. We didn't even know each other anymore. It was just, it was weird. And so anyway, I was writing it in a hotel bathroom, and I wrote it over this like voice memo chord progression that I had in my head. And it just sounded too like, not what it felt like. Like it felt like what the song sounds like now.
Mm-hmm.
And before, I was like, how did we let it all get this far? I don't even know who you are. It was like, And so I saw like the person that I initially wrote it about at this thing. I just went into the bathroom and I just started like, it was like a movie. I just was like crying. And then I came out into the social gathering thing, and I was just kind of like, you know, pretended like nothing was wrong. In a romantic situation, you kind of, it's not surprising if you break up, if that makes sense. Like, you don't, it's not like you expect it, but it's like, man, we broke up, it didn't work out.
It happens.
Exactly, it happens. But I feel like with a friendship, when that ends, like, in a different way, that hurts.
Right.
I Have Questions was the first song where I was like, I have to get this out. And after that, I wrote like every song about that situation until I was over it. I was like, you know what? I don't have anything to say about this anymore. And I, again, to Lily's point, I just let it go.
Last question. You know, with the album, I mean, there's so much that has been said about you, tweeted about you, mm-hmm. written about you. What do you want people to take away when they take this Camila album home and listen to it, or when they stream it and wherever they absorb it? What do you want the takeaway to be? What do you want people to understand walking away from this?
I mean, hopefully I don't even have to say it. Hopefully they just understand when they listen to it that everything, every song on here came from notes in my phone. Like, it came from something real that happened to me. Or something that I felt, or sorry, you know what I mean? Quiet, and I think that just makes the experience, the listening experience, more real.
It was a big step to step out on your own and say, I'm going to give you all of me, mm-hmm. whether you like it or not, and accept it. And the fact that you did it in the music is amazing.
Thank you.
This makes it all more special.
Thank you so much.
All right.
Thanks. All right. You're the best, man. Thank you.
You're the best.
That was the most powerful thing.
Right? Wow. That was crazy. I'm very impressed by the fact that her album was literally, like she said, written using notes on her phone. I think is amazing. And we were wondering, since she broke off from Fifth Harmony, how did she, like, where did she get her ideas from? If she had been writing,
and while she was
with the group, mm-hmm. And I think that's.
I wonder if they were, the managers in the studio were okay with that.
With her writing her own stuff while she was in the group.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I don't think they were probably like monitoring that. I mean, I feel like she would have free rein to be able to, like, just write. I mean, it's not like she was producing something on her own But I think, like I said, we're sorry that we didn't talk throughout that whole thing, but I was just very absorbed in what she was saying.
Actually, like, kind of taken back by that.
On the more serious note, I think that if, I know that there has been and probably still are a lot of opinions about Camila and then her breaking off from Fifth Harmony, but I feel like everyone who had questions about that needs to definitely watch this video, because I feel like it was very informative in the fact that she didn't leave Fifth Harmony to be spiteful. I mean, that's obvious. She left Fifth Harmony because she wanted to pursue her own dreams, mm-hmm. and she wasn't able to do that in Fifth Harmony. You know, being under the management, I assume, is what caused her to not be able to do her
I think
own
some
stuff.
Of you guys in the comments said that they had a problem with their management and their studio. And
And obviously, you could see that if she said that she was disconnected from the songs because they weren't her own.
Yeah.
And I feel like as an artist, it would be really cool to see your own stuff put out and something that's personal to you. I know that this is completely, like, irrelevant and nothing really compared to what she's gone through, but, like, when we post, like, our own videos, we're always so nervous about it, but then we take pride in posting our own stuff because it's our own stuff. But I'm just saying, like, as an example, like, like, when you post your own stuff, you have, it's like, people like me for me and not for, you know, like, people like her for the stuff that she's writing, the stuff she's gone through, rather songs that were written for her that she's singing.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, it's definitely more personal for her, and it was very cool getting to see her perspective on the whole situation and everything that's happened to her. Mm-hmm. On a less serious note, I do want to visit a psychic now.
I do too.
Because that's,
I've been really wanting to do that.
I think it's crazy.
Separately or together?
I want to go, like,
if we ever do that,
together.
We should vlog it.
Yeah.
No, I don't know, because we might learn some stuff in the future that we don't want to hear.
Well, we can go together and then we can do separate readings. Or we can just tell her not to tell us anything negative about us.
Well, it sounds like you have to hear it when she said that.
Yeah, well, you know my obsession for Tyler the medium. I love Tyler and he's, like, amazing. But I watch all of his videos and I find the whole thing, like, absolutely, he's not a fortune psychic. He's a medium. And I tend to watch more towards a medium. But they do give, like, information about a person's future and stuff. And it just, like, it's mind-blowing to me, the fact that people, because I truly believe in stuff, that people know and are able to tap into stuff like that, because I'm just so interested to see.
Yeah.
I don't know, to see what people would read from both you and I. It'd be probably really cool. I want to see my mom's reading. Hers would probably be, like, wickedly awesome.
Okay.
Yeah. I feel.
Why?
Well, like a medium reading.
Yeah.
Like if someone came through, I'm sure her mom would come through.
Yeah, I'm sure. But I really want to. So. Actually, if you guys know any, like, really professional mediums or something.
Well, yeah. Well, there's the one in New Jersey.
Like, legit? Like.
Mm-hmm.
Let us know, though, anyways, down below. Because I'm really curious.
I'm blanking on her name, y'all.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah.
But I'm really curious because I really want to do that someday and maybe vlog that.
Yeah, that'd be a really great vlog. Anyway, I'm excited that we finally got to that video. So thank you guys. Thank you to everyone who requested it. I enjoyed it. I'm assuming you enjoyed
it. Yeah, well, I'm still kind of like
zoned into that.
Yeah, it drains me.
Because it's just like so much to take in. I'm sure it was a lot for her to take in too.
Yeah.
But if you guys have any more Camila videos that you want us to watch, please leave them in the comments below. And if you guys want to see more of us, make sure to check out the description box below. Go to our Snapchat and Instagram. Make sure to subscribe.
And as always, thank you for support. Thank you for love. We love
you guys.
Every single one of you. Have a good night. Have a good day.
Bye.
Bye.